sit around and wait for the one who's in power to make up his mind that he should end it, you'll be waiting a long time. And in my opinion, the young generation of whites, blacks, brown, whatever else there is, you're living at a time of extremism, a time of revolution, a time when there's got to be a change. People in power have misused it, and now there has to be a change, and a better world has to be built, and the only way it's going to be built is with extreme methods. And I, for one, will join in with anyone, don't care what color you are, as long as you want to change this miserable condition that exists on this earth. Thank you.
Some of the things that frustrate me is simply chalking things up to being racial, and someone, because of their ethnic background, they can't do X, Y, or Z.
This racial stuff been going on for like a minute.
Honestly, racism just needs to end. You know, we've been saying it for years, for lots of years. It hasn't, I mean, it's changed, it's evolved in a way, but really it just needs to stop.
Everybody don't go by the same stereotypes. Some people are raised differently in their household from another black person raised in their home. Everybody's different.
I think sometimes I'm frustrated when groups of people, regardless to ethnicity, but in particular black people, are lumped together. Like, well, all of y'all do this. No, we don't. All of y'all don't do this. No, that's not true, right? So we each have our own experiences, and I think that the more we can recognize that and acknowledge that, again, that's part of the pathway forward.
I'm multiracial, and my mom is white, my dad is black, and so growing up, it was hard for me to even know what my racial identity was.
The term African American, right? People are always like, do you mind? And I'm like, I don't. However, my mother is an islander. She's Bermudian. She's from Bermuda, citizenship in Bermuda, born in Bermuda, raised in Bermuda. And so I'm like, I don't know that we go back to Africa in my particular family lineage. As much as I have studied back to the 1870s, so not back that far, we were in the West Indies. So I'm sure at some point, perhaps, it was Africa.
It's complicated for a person like me, but I think it's complicated for a lot of people because, you know, race can be part of your, or it is part of your identity, but that doesn't mean it defines everything about you. And so I think, you know, understanding that all of us have culture and heritage that we value and think is important, and also understanding that everybody's an individual.
The way we talk, the way we act, our music, all of that, our culture, it's people misunderstand it to be like things that's like rebellious or savage or gangster or things like that, but it's really like things that bring us together, what we had to make, because we came to this country with our history stripped away from us, so we had to recreate a whole new history in African-American culture that we have today. And it's misunderstood by some people and it's appropriated by others, but at the same time, it's like what is ours, like it's what makes us who we are.
People take advantage of the meaning behind our music, behind our food. A lot of people like to wear our clothing, the way we do our hair.
Our style and or like the clothes we wear, the hair we wear. Yeah, our hair, like they'll ask us if it's our real hair, like that's an insult a little bit.
Feels like when people try on that type of stuff as if it's a costume and they don't understand the meanings behind it, it takes away a part of you.
Other things is our slang, like where we come from, they'll say you talk ghetto or something, but no, I don't think this is how you talk.
Because I use slang, because I don't care about looking prim and proper, people assume that you're less intelligent. Just like people that are ESL, English as a second language, people that are learning how to speak English, we assume because you don't speak English, you're not smart. That's a bias that we have as Americans.
Yeah, they really just don't understand us as a whole. And instead of getting to know us, asking about it, they pick on us and provoke us and do things that make us want to like push away, and then they wonder why we're like all divided instead of together and united.
Well, there's jokes that people say about black people. Oh, we're aggressive. Oh, she's ghetto. Why does she talk like that? Why does she look like that? Why is she built like that? And people constantly make jokes about it, and they might just be like, oh, it was just a joke. I was just kidding. It doesn't mean anything. But they need to get educated on it because there's people that have different backgrounds and they don't know what could happen in their life, what could have happened in their family, and I think they should just know what they're saying because it could really hurt somebody.
It was hard to find someone to connect to my own personal struggles as a Black woman, as a Black student in a predominantly white neighborhood. So it stresses me seeing these young kids trying to figure out the world, especially today's world, without having someone in class who sees them and understands the deeply rooted culture and history that is behind being Black.
And I know I went to a D211 school and there were so many awkward moments where I would be sitting in a class and I would be the only in that particular class and a topic would come up and everyone would be like, so what do you think? And they would look directly to me as if I were the spokesperson for all things Black. That is frustrating. It is frustrating as a teenager because you can't even, you don't necessarily understand why you're frustrated. But then as an adult, it continues.
I would like to just see more equal opportunities for all students, regardless of community, regardless of zip code where you live at. At our school, we do a good job of providing opportunities. I feel like, hey, we have made tremendous progress, but I would like to see those opportunities to other areas.
I feel like I can make an impact in certain places, but not in the places I want to make an impact on.
There isn't like a lot of patience.
Nobody wants to better us because it's like they only want to hear everything that's negative. What about the things that we did to help like the country?
I feel like in school, like we should have like a Black history class to actually like talk about our history.
Like, we need it.
I've never learned anything new in a history class. Oh, well, when it comes to Black history. They always tell half and parts of the story, and I'm like, I'm Black, so I want to know my history. I wanted to know where I came from, rather good or bad.
Because we have not historically had the luxury of being able to make mistakes. We're not able to bounce back from things other cultures have.
There are definitely people that are trying, but at least most people in powers of authority. Back during the Black Lives Matter movement in 2020, there were so many like politicians and influencers that would just say Black Lives Matter to save face so that they wouldn't be get canceled. And it's frustrating to me how yet they say that they aren't really doing anything and nothing has really changed.
I don't think there's a negative about being Black. I think people can see it as being bad because of the things that happens in the community, like Chicago shootings and stuff, but that's not a thing that you should put on all Black people. That's just that situation for that city.
Well, I would say like we're looked at as a threat because police will find any reason to try to shoot you or anything. Somebody will pull something out their pocket and they'll think it's a gun just because we're Black.
The power that the police have, I really think is just crazy.
Definitely the police. I don't hate the police, but like times I've gotten pulled over or my friends gotten pulled over, like I'm instantly like just thinking like what could happen because I see everything that's happening to people that look like me and I just think that any moment could like just be my last sometimes.
They don't see a Black man how they see a white man walking on the street. They see the Black man as a threat or as dangerous. They don't see people the same way because of our skin color, and I just don't agree, and I don't think it's fair.
If I had to pinpoint something that people misunderstand, is that we are loving people. We are caring people. We are energetic people. We are fantastic people. We are not dangerous people. We are not scary people. We are exceptional people, just like you.
People may misunderstand how Blacks communicate. Sometimes it can be seen as rude or offensive by our volume or by our engagement. But really it's just, we're colorful people. And I don't say that just from an external standpoint, but internally as well.
People assume a lot, Like people be like, oh, you eat watermelon, oh, you eat chicken.
They think they know.
I don't even eat chicken like that.
That's lying. Even if we do fit into some stereotypes, that don't mean that that's all we are.
Common misconceptions about being black. Eating ramen noodles as their favorite food. And they always have it in their house, grape juice. There's a whole bunch of other funny things. But yeah, we're not different. We do the same thing.
Underneath the body, underneath the skin color, we all the same flesh, all the same blood.
We wear our emotions on our sleeves. And so I think sometimes that can be a little intimidating or a little shocking for some. But I think that's something that I realized, that our communication is what it is. It's just very emotional at times, but it's passionate. And I feel that's an area that I feel that sometimes gets misunderstood.
Each and every human, black, white, or otherwise, has their own experience and their own interaction with the world.
Own who you are, be who you are, and you gotta take some lumps along the way, but you'll be happy in the long run if you commit to who you are.
It bothers me when people downplay the role that race plays. I wouldn't say that it's part of everything, but it is a very pressing issue, especially if you're impacted by it directly. And so I guess the frustration for me is when people want to not even talk about race, or, you know, I'm colorblind, or I don't see color. It goes back to, well, that's a part of who I am. So to say that you don't see that, that's actually an insult. But I think we do need to see the differences that we all have. We need to see the similarities we all have, and we need to treat everybody in a humane way that all of us deserve.
A lot of cultures, but I can speak to the black culture, we stress being genuine. And when we feel like someone's lying to us, or we feel like someone's not being 100% straightforward with us, we don't trust you, we don't like you. And that's hard, because a lot of communication is manipulation. We're always trying to be seen in the best light. We're always trying to get things to work in our favor. But we don't like to deal with people that we can see through. And that is a huge thing.
Everyone has his or her own unique experiences. And the more we get to know an individual person, I think the better the path forward can be as it pertains to healing, as it pertains to understanding, as it pertains to really all of the characteristics and the things that we need to have in place for community, right? Like, the better we understand one another, the more we know about one another, the easier it is to that pathway forward. Where the baby blues birds fly, and gray clouds, or white walls, or blue skies, we gon' fly, feel alright. Somebody help me feel alright tonight. Now we gon' do.